The Intel Arc A750 had a rocky start, launching after the GPU shortage and with notoriously bad drivers. It seemed like its existence was pointless, for many who saw Arc as a savior during the shortage, offering gamers with another option at a much cheaper price. But things have changed. Recent driver improvements and a price drop to just $199 made the Arc A750 an excellent value, even better than the RX 6650 XT. That's a deal for a card that can handle many of the most demanding games on the market. But how does it compare to cards in its price range? That is what I am here to find out. In this video, I will be reviewing the Intel Arc A750 and showing you what it can do, taking a closer look at the specs. The A750 immediately stands out. It rivals the 3060 in cores and has significantly higher TMU and ROP counts, even higher than the 3060 Ti, and much higher than the 6650 and 6750 XT. While it does have slightly fewer cores, its identical memory bus puts it closer to a 3060 Ti. The 3060 does have more memory, which could give it an edge in more demanding titles that require more memory, something that is especially important nowadays. But that's not all. The A750 has significantly higher clocks, like the RX 6650 XT, in addition to its higher TMU and ROP counts. It also has higher memory speeds than the 3060, making it a fierce contender. But really, it comes down to the price. The A750 is priced at $199 USD, the cheapest card here by far. It is $61 less than the 3060 and $46 less than the 6650 XT. With all these features, I would say the Arc A750 is already an absolute steal. It has similar specs to even a 3060 Ti, but we will have to see if that holds up when we can compare all these cards in 10 games both 1080p and 1440p, with ray tracing and rasterization, and some benchmarks. Starting off with 1080p traditional rasterization, the A750's performance was particularly good. In some games like Cyberpunk 2077, it outperformed both the 6650 XT and 3060, but in others it struggled a bit, and even fell short of the 1660, yes, the 1660 in some cases. While Intel has been doing well in improving drivers for newer, more intensive games like Cyberpunk 2077, they have not quite hit the ground running with all the APIs yet, but there has been some improvement in recent months. We're running this on the newest driver from Intel though, and we'll have a driver comparison with the launch driver versus the latest driver in a separate video, coming to the channel soon, so stay tuned for that. Looking at the average numbers for 1080p, both the 3060 and 6650 XT outperformed the A750 by a considerable 24%, but don't forget about that price difference. Being $46 cheaper than the 6650 XT means it could be an even better value. The A750 is not really a 1440p card, but we couldn't resist putting it to the test. And the story at 1440p is the same as 1080p, with one exception, Cyberpunk 2077. In that game, the A750 led the pack of the mid-range cards, beating all of them, but it fell short in every other case. However, this time it came a lot closer to the 6650 XT and 3060, with the gap narrowing compared to 1080p in some cases. Looking at the average FPS for 1440p, the 3060 still outperformed the Arc A750 by a noticeable 30%, with the 6650 XT outpacing it by 33%. Despite the A750 being on par in specs with the 3060 Ti, the 3060 Ti outperformed it by a whopping 57%. This brings us to the full summary for rasterization of both 1080p and 1440p. The A750 fails to impress, with the 3060 and 6650 XT outpacing it by around 30%, and the 3060 Ti and 6750 XT outpacing it by around 50%. But despite this, its value is wicked. It leads the chart in performance per dollar, even overthrowing the previous value king, the 6650 XT, by 11%. This makes it the new top dog for value, but it's not surprising given that it's $46 cheaper and has fairly satisfactory performance for the price. Its power consumption is also pretty tame, drawing 9% less than the 3060. It does draw a bit more than the 6650 XT by 13%. However, its overall average efficiency is not great. It ends up at the bottom of the chart, with the 6650 XT still being the most efficient. This tells us that there is still some improvements to be had with this card regarding drivers. It delivered fewer performance than the other cards at a similar power draw. The 6650 XT is still a whopping 45% more efficient, while even the 3060 is significantly more efficient, providing 13% more performance per watt than the A750. Overall, the A750's performance is a mixed bag, but its value is truly where it shines, being the new top dog for overall value. Its power draw is good, but unsurprisingly, given its performance, it is not quite up up to snuff when it comes to performance per watt. It is held back by this, and as a result, it is not very efficient. When it comes to ray tracing in 1080p, the tables start to turn. The A750 delivers surprisingly satisfactory performance overall, even beating the 3060 in some cases, like in Hitman. It shines its way through, completely obliterating the two Radeon cards. More often than not, its driver improvements are on full display here. Looking at the average FPS for 1080p ray tracing, the Arc A750 outperforms the 6650 XT by 22% and comes within a hair's length of the 3060, which only outpaces it by 10%. This is really impressive stuff. It means that the Arc A750's value wins in rasterization could very much carry over into ray tracing as well. The story continues nicely into 1440p, where the A750 still pulls impressive wins against the 6650 XT. Similar to 1080p in Hitman 3, it ends up skyrocketing, this time even beating the 3060. Overall, it was a valuable experience with this card, and I was impressed with how it performed. Looking at the averages for 1440p, the A750 pulls ahead of the 6650 XT by a respectable 26%, with the 3060 still leading it by 16%. This brings us to the averages for both 1080p and 1440p, where the A750 leads overall in ray tracing versus the 6650 XT by 23%, with the 3060 just trailing it by 12%. It is pretty impressive that the Arc A750 is able to beat the 6650 XT in ray tracing, while also being pretty close to the 3060. Intel should be proud of that fact. Beating AMD and being in the rearview mirror of NVIDIA is hugely impressive. This bodes incredibly well for its value in ray tracing. It is impressive performance and great price that go hand in hand to deliver the best value in ray tracing by a long shot. It gives an out of this world 50% more performance per dollar than even the 3060, and a whopping 75% higher performance per dollar than the 6650 XT. It is even a better value than the 3060 Ti by 40%. But did it come at much of a cost of power consumption? Not really. It does draw more power than the 6650 XT by 29%, but it still draws less than the 3060, which draws 5% more. This leads us to the overall power efficiency for ray tracing. While it is not the most efficient card, it manages to outpace the 6750 XT. Overall, the A750 performs well in ray tracing, beating the 6650 XT and comes close to the 3060. This is impressive and shows that Intel has done a decent job with this card. Its impressive performance and great price made it an excellent value for ray tracing. It delivers more performance per dollar than even the 3060, and much more than the 6650 XT. It is even better value than the 3060 Ti. Its power consumption is reasonable and is more power efficient than the 6650 XT. Intel should really give themselves a pat on the back. Being able to beat AMD in ray tracing while coming close to NVIDIA is nothing short of impressive. I hope to see more driver improvements in the future, adding even more value to this already terrific value card. Moving on to some more general benchmarks. This is where the Arc A750 really shines. But do take this with a grain of salt. In 30-mark time spot, the A750 absolutely embarrasses the 3060 by jaw-dropping 41%. It even beats the 3060 Ti by 8%. It also outpaces the 6650 XT by 21%. But why do I say take this with a grain of salt? Because of the massive performance delta we saw compared to rasterization. We were not seeing the A750 pulling these kinds of wins in those 10 games. This is purely because this benchmark would have been first on Intel's agenda when optimizing the A750. Remember, this is a DX12 benchmark. It is obvious that Intel optimized these benchmarks first to top the charts, but that does not take away from the fact that it is still a substantial value anyway. It tells us there is still a lot of untapped performance left on the table, and that Intel has a long way to go. But enough of that. Let's look at this ray tracing performance in port rayout. Once again, it leads over all the other GPUs. Even the 6750 XT, while coming close to the 3060 Ti, it leads the 6650 XT by a significant 41% and the 3060 by 29%. This comes as no surprise. As we saw in ray tracing in Hitman 3, more prominently at 1440p, it ends up topping all the other cards. This goes to show how optimized Hitman 3 is for Arc. This brings us to some productivity benchmarks. In the Adobe suite, starting with Premiere Pro, it performs adequately, taking the lead over the 3060 by 5% and the 6650 XT by 27%. In After Effects, it does end up losing to the 3060, which beats it by 34%, but the Arc A750 still takes the cake over the 6650 XT by 4%. Now, overclocking on the A750 is a bit different to what you're used to. For starters, you're only able to control settings using the Intel Arc control software, and secondly, there is no individual clock controls for the core and memory clocks. Instead, Intel applies a curve for both the core and memory based on a percentage altered by the GPU performance slider in Arc control. However, you can still adjust the voltage through an offset and the power limit. So we set the boost to 40 while setting the voltage offset to plus 100 millivolts, while lastly putting the power limit to the max of 228 watts. This netted a small boost in average FPS by a steady 2% in Heaven benchmark, with the 1 and 0.1% lows not changing significantly either. What did end up changing significantly was the average power draw, which increased by a whopping 31%, with the average temp also increasing by 8%, while finally the noise levels noticeably increased by 20%. Overall, pretty disappointing results for overclocking on the A750. Power increased by a huge margin, while only delivering a mere performance bump. It is clear that some work is still to be done from Intel here as well. In conclusion, the Intel Arc A750 has proven itself to be a surprising contender in the GPU market. Despite its rocky start with poor drivers and launching after the GPU shortage, recent improvements have transformed it into an excellent value proposition, even better than the previous king, the 6650 XT. With the price drop to just $199 USD and impressive specs comparable to even the higher end 3060 Ti, the A750 offers great performance for its price. It offers impressive value for its price, delivering satisfactory performance in both rasterization and ray tracing. While it may not be the most efficient option, its competitive pricing and solid performance make it a worthwhile choice for gamers on a budget. With further driver improvements and optimization, Intel has the potential to continue making strides in the GPU market. Anyways guys, that's all for today. Make sure to like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell. Also make sure to check out this video on screen right now.